Welcome to this Back to Basics course on cost behaviours. My name is Jo Tuffle and I'm the ACCA PM tutor at FME Learn Online. Why is it important to understand about cost behaviour? Well, it's important because it's vital for informed business decisions. Business decisions such as setting prices, determining break-even point, creating a budget, or calculating your profitability. So what is a cost? Well, the term cost refers to any expense of a business incurred in production and selling. And there are two types: variable costs and fixed costs. Let's look at each of those in turn now. Now, firstly, variable costs are any expense that changes as you produce more or sell. The main types are raw materials and labour. So if we were to graph it, as output increases, so do total variable costs. Now let's suppose our company makes candles and the variable cost per unit is $7. Now, if you make 50 units, 50 times 7 is going to be $350. And if you make 100 units, 100 times 7 is going to be $700. So as output goes up, so do costs. Now, fixed costs are expenses that remain the same no matter how much the company produces. It's actually independent of business activity, and it's things like rent, property tax, insurance, and depreciation. Again, if we were to graph it, the fixed costs will remain the same regardless. You cannot avoid them. So in our example, let's say the fixed costs are 1,000. At 0 units, it's still 1,000. And if we were to produce 1,000 units, it would still be 1,000. Now let me introduce you to Clara and her candles. Clara's candles are very on trend for the millennials, who want urban-themed candles at an inexpensive price. She's been selling online direct through her website and Instagram Facebook accounts. She has a problem though. She wants to know if she's selling at the right price to make a profit. She wants your help. Now, Clara's candles prices and costs are as follows. She's selling them at $15. She has total variable costs per unit of 7. This means that she makes $8 every time she sells a candle. This is called contribution. And it means contributing towards your fixed costs. So in order to make a profit, she needs to sell enough to cover her fixed costs of $1,000 a month. So how many candles must Clara produce to cover her fixed costs to start making a profit? We call this her break-even point. And we call the process of finding it break-even analysis. We can plot this on a chart. We're going to plot revenue and costs now to find that break-even point. Revenue goes up as output goes up. The more you sell, the more you get in revenue. Fixed costs remain the same, remember, whatever the output level. If we apply variable costs on top of those fixed costs, which go up as output increases, then we'll get a total cost line. Where those two points cross, where revenue equals total costs, is called our break-even point. And this will therefore tell Clara how much she needs to make in order to start making a profit. And that will be 125 candles. Now we get that from dividing the fixed costs of 1,000 per month by the $8 contribution that we get from the sales price minus the variable costs per unit. So it's 125 candles. We can now give Clara some advice.
So what do you advise Clara? Well, Clara, if you sell 125 candles a month, you'll cover your costs. But if you sell more, you'll start making a profit. Now, if you think that's not achievable, then there's three options. Number one, you can raise your prices. Number two, you can reduce your variable cost per unit. And number three, you can reduce your overall fixed cost per month. Now, all three of these options will reduce her break-even point. But a combination of all three could significantly improve her chances of making a good profit per month. Let's have a look at that now.
So let's have a look at doing a combination of all three options, moving prices up and costs down by 10%. The revenue line would now look steeper as the prices increase by 10% to $16.50. The fixed cost line would move down by 10% to $900. And then if we add a variable cost now of $6.30, which is 10% less than the $7, this now means the total cost line is shallower and therefore the break-even point is now lower. And this is 89 candles, which we get from taking the fixed cost now of 900 divided by the contribution per unit of 1020, which is the 1650 price minus the 630 variable cost. So overall, we're now at 89 candles to break even. Therefore, you can advise Clara, if she's able to sell 125 candles a month, she'll be able to make a profit of $375 a month.
So I hope you can see that an understanding of a business's cost structure is fundamental to its success. And that's why it's the first concept that's taught in management accounting. I hope you've enjoyed this Back to Basics course. Thank you for watching and listening.